Laser radar with improved software reliability factor. Abstract. Introduction to radar systems. 94 GHz by about 5 dB, on average, then horizontal polarization, which is the opposite to the experience at microwaves. It should be cautioned that the few measurements available were taken at low grazing angle and over a limited range of wind speeds. As with trees and grass, the value of 2 for snow increases with frequency and grazing angle. 0.77.78.102 crusted snow, that which has melted and refrozen, produces higher values of 2 at 35 GHz and 94 GHz than wet snow, grass, or trees. At microwaves, the backscatter from rain can be explained according to the Rayleigh scattering model, with the reflectivity varying as the fourth power of the frequency. The clear air attenuation. A fair weather cumulus cloud has low attenuation at millimeter wavelengths. A one-way attenuation of 0.3 dB/km at 94 GHz might not be significant for short-range radar, but it can be overwhelming for long-range radar. For example, a 5 km radar will experience a two-way attenuation of 3 dB, which is tolerable in most situations. A 50 km radar, however, will have 30 dB attenuation, which is usually intolerable. Thus, long-range radar is not likely at millimeter wavelengths under normal circumstances. Although the attenuation at Nalernaker wavelengths is far greater than that at microwave wavelengths, the losses it occurred in propagating millimeter wavelengths through fog, haze, and smoke is less than at infrared or visible wavelengths. An outlier example where a particular property of millimeter wave radar has both favorable and unfavorable aspects is that of the Doppler frequency shift. It was shown in sector 3.1 that Tlick Doppler frequency shift was proportional to the carrier, RF, frequency. This rest LTS in more accurate relative velocity measurements with millimeter wavelengths than at lower frequencies. The large Doppler shifts at millimeter wavelengths, however, can sometimes result in the echo signal being outside the receiver bandwidth, which complicates the receiver design. Also, the large Doppler frequencies at millimeter wavelengths cause the blind speeds of MTI radars to appear at lower velocities than at microwaves, an undesirable property. Thus, a frustrating paradox of the millimeter wavelength region is that some of its claimed good points are also its weaknesses. Clutter at millimeter wavelengths. In Chapter 13, it was implied that knowledge of radar clutter characteristics at microwaves was less than desired. There is even less information on clutter at frequencies above 10 GHz. Details will not be given here, but the general trends will be summarized for the several types of clutter that have been measured. The AN range clutter cross-section per unit area for one set of measurements of trees and vegetation at millimeter wavelengths is given by 75.102. AO, dB, equals 20 plus 10 log 0125 15 log r 14.37 Bullock. 0 is TLE grazing angle in degrees and r is in centimeters. Thus, A0 increases with increasing frequency. Vertical polarization produced echoes 3 to 4 dB greater than horizontal polarization. These measurements were made in Georgia during the summer and fall months and included deciduous trees and pine trees. The grazing angles were from 2 to 25. The pulse. These measurements were made in Georgia during the summer and fall months and included deciduous trees and pine trees. The grazing angles were from 2 to 25 degrees. The pulse width was 100 ns and the antenna beam width was in the vicinity of 1 degree. The value of 0 to 0 for C clutter at low grazing angle and low winds has been reported 76.2. But not increase with frequency much above X-band, but also 77. The trend of increasing reflectivity with decreasing wavelength also holds for sea clutter, although the effect is not nearly as pronounced as for land clutter. However, both references state that for higher sea states, the maximum wind speed was 14 knots, the value of 0 to 0 at 94 GHz is less than that at X-hand. Another observation is that vertical polarization seems to produce lower values of 0 to 0 at 94 GHz by about 5 dB, on average, than horizontal polarization, which is the opposite to the experience at microwaves. It should be cautioned that the few mesurements available were taken at low grazing angle and over a limited range of wind speeds. As with trees and grass, the value of A0 for snow increases with frequency and grazing angle. 0.77-78,102 crusted snow, that which has melted and refrozen, produces higher vault ES of O0 at 35 GHz and 94 GHz than wet snow, grass, or trees. At microwaves, the backscatter from rain can be explained according to the Rayleigh scattering model, with the reflectivity varying as the fourth power of the frequency, sector 13.7. In the millimeter wave region, the drop sizes of the raindrops span both the Rayleigh and the Mie scattering regions, so that a difference in behavior can be expected. Experimental measurements indicated that, on the average, the radar backscatter at 9.4 and 35 GHz far appeared to follow the Rayleigh scattering. Deviations from Rayleigh were found at 70 and 95 GHz, and the backscatter at 95 GHz was observed to be less than at 70 GHz. The backscatter at millimeter waves was found to depend on the drop signal distribution of the precipitation. 0.102 Even though the rain rates were the same, the backscatter from rain containing drops 2 to 6 mm in diameter was approximately 10 dB greater than rain containing drops 1 mm in diameter or less. The amplitude fluctuations of the rain backscatter were approximated by a log-normal probability distribution over the range from 9.4 to 94 GHz and at rain rates from 1 mm/h to 60 mm/h. The variance, and standard deviation, of the log-normal distribution was independent of rain rate and decreased with increasing frequency. The decorrelation times at 95 GHz varied from about 3.4 milliseconds at 5 mm/h rain rate to 1.4 milliseconds at 100 mm/h. At X-band, the decorrelation times were longer and varied from 14 milliseconds at 5 mm/h to 5.4 milliseconds at 100 mm/h. Utility of millimeter waves. Experimentation with millimeter wavelength radiation and microwave radiation both date back to the end of the 19th century. The first microwave experiments were those of Hertz in 1886. Experiments at 6 mm wavelength occurred in 1895.80. In the early 1920s, millimeter wave research was reported in the United States, Germany, and Russia, with wavelengths as short as 0.22 mm 81. Although many important applications of the microwave region have been developed, there has been almost no comparable activity in the millimeter wave region. There are many possible reasons for this lack of activity, including lack of adequate millimeter wave components, small antenna sizes, and difficult MTI. RUT. The most restricting of all has been the relatively large attenuations experienced when propagating through the clear atmosphere, as well as the added attenuation during rain. The large attenuations are likely to limit millimeter radar to short-range applications where the total attenuations are tolerable, or to applications where the atmosphere is absent, such as in space or at very high altitudes. Millimeter wavelengths might also find application when the propagation path does not traverse a large part of the Earth's atmosphere, as when a ground-based radar directs its energy at or near the zenith. At 94 GHz, the two-way loss in transiting the entire atmosphere is about 1.7 dB at zenith, 3.5 dB at 60 from the zenith, and 10 dB at 80 from the zenith. 82 sub-millimeter wavelengths. 0.83s84 The advantages of high resolution, wide bandwidth, and small antenna aperture are even more prevalent in the sub-millimeter proportion of the electromagnetic spectrum than at millimeters. The attenuation in the clear atmosphere, however, is far worse than at millimeters and varies from about 10 dB/km at LMM wavelength to more than 100 dB/km at 0.1 mm wavelength. Laser radar with improved reliability. The large attenuations experienced in clear air in the millimeter, 60 GHz, and submillimeter regions are not present in the infrared and visible regions of the spectrum. 564 Introduction to radar systems. 94 GHz by about 5 dB, on average, then horizontal polarization, which is the opposite to the experience at microwaves. It should be cautioned that the few measurements available were taken at low grazing angle and over a limited range of wind speeds. As with trees and grass, the value of 2 for snow increases with frequency and grazing angle. 77.78.102 Crusted snow, that which has melted and refrozen, produces higher values of 2 at 35 GHz and 94 GHz than wet snow, grass, or trees. At microwaves, the backscatter from rain can be explained according to the Rayleigh scattering model, with the reflectivity varying as the fourth power of the frequency, sector 13.7. In the millimeter wave region, the drop sizes of the raindrops span both the Rayleigh and the Mie scattering regions, so that a difference in behavior can be expected. Experimental measurements indicated that, on the average, the radar backscatter at 9.4 and 35 GHz appeared to follow the Rayleigh scattering law. 79.102 Deviations from Rayleigh were found at 70 and 95 GHz, and the backscatter at 95 GHz was observed to be less than at 70 GHz. The backscatter, the millimeter waves, was found to depend on the drop size distribution of the precipitation. 102 Even though the rain rates were the same, the backscatter from rain containing drops 2 to 6 millimeters in diameter was approximately 10 dB greater than rain containing drops 1 millimeter in diameter or less. The amplitude fluctuations of the rain backscatter were approximated by a log-normal probability distribution over the range from 9.4 to 94 GHz and at rain rates from 1 mm/h to 60 mm/h. The variance, and standard deviation, of the log-normal distribution was independent of rain rate and decreased with increasing frequency. The decorrelation times at 95 GHz varied from about 3.4 milliseconds at 5 mm/h rain rate to 1.4 milliseconds at 100 mm/h. At X-band, the decorrelation times were longer and varied from 14 milliseconds at 5 mm/h to 5.4 milliseconds at 100 mm/h. Utility of millimeter waves. Experimentation with millimeter wavelength radiation and microwave radiation both date back to the end of the 19th century. The first microwave experiments were those of Hertz in 1886. Experiments at 6 mm wavelength occurred in 1895.80. In the early 1920s, millimeter wave research was reported in the United States, Germany, and Russia, with wavelengths as short as 0.22 millimeters 81. Although many important applications of the microwave region have been developed, there has been almost no comparable activity in the millimeter wave region. There are many possible reasons for this lack of activity, including lack of adequate millimeter wave components, small antenna sizes, and difficult MTI. But the most restricting of all has been the relatively large attenuations experienced when propagating through the clear atmosphere, as well as the added attenuation during rain. The large attenuations are likely to limit millimeter radar to short-range applications where the total attenuations are tolerable, or to applications where the atmosphere is absent, such as in space or at very high altitudes. Millimeter wavelengths might also find application when the propagation path does not traverse a large part of the Earth's atmosphere, as when a ground-based radar directs its energy at or near the zenith. At 94 GHz, the two-way loss in transiting the entire atmosphere is about 1.7 dB at zenith, 3.5 dB at 60 degrees from the zenith, and 10 dB at 80 degrees from the zenith, 82 sub-millimeter wavelengths. 84 The advantages of high resolution, wide bandwidth, and small antenna aperture are even more prevalent in the sub-millimeter proportion of the electromagnetic spectrum than at millimeters. The attenuation in the clear atmosphere, however, is far worse than at millimeters and varies from about 10 dB/km at IMM wavelength to more than 1000 dB/km at OJMM wavelength. Laser radar. The large attenuations experienced in clear air in the millimeter, 60 GHz, and sub-millimeter regions are not present in the infrared and visible regions of the spectrum, Fig. 14.15. The attenuato in rain. Eochber. Is still large. Thus laser radars operating in the infrared and visible regions achieve the advantages of high angular resolution, wide bandwidth, and Doppler frequency sensitivity without the accompanying disadvantage of high attenuation as experienced in the sub-millimeter region. Because of its SNR is all physical aperture, a laser radar is riot suited for most surveillance APL locations. It is, however, well suited for precision reniasuri leti and target imaging. The RFSIGRI of a laser radar follows the same general principles as outlier radars, but with some exceptions. R5.93.94.105-111 fission to using a transradiator. Unlike those found at microwave frequencies, the laser radar CXL its outlikerdif SCRCRCCS that NIRST be accounted for OLIKN considering radar desigli. Forks and MITK. Tile receiver sensitivity is riot determined by thermal noise as at microwaves, hut by Kili ITT2 ISECT. ILIK TOSCI, OWCI. Per ILTED batted Whitley at most laser frequencies is given by / V LIKRIK / I equals Planck's Coley stand equals 6.626 × 10 J.S, AND / equals frequency. The familiar expression for thermal noise power at microwave frequencies, NO equals KT, where K equals Boltzmann's constant arid 7 equals absolute temperature, does not apply when KTQ it is the coarseness of the laser signal itself, due to its quantized nature, TLIAT ultimately sets TLI limit to sensitivity as given by IQ, 14.3x. 13y set IRIG K7, equals LRFL and EKI IVALETI noise temperature can be obtained for a laser receiver. At the CO, laser wavelength of 10.6 pm, t. equals 1360 k and at 1.0 pm wavelength 7. Equals 14.400 k, which it indicates that laser radar receivers are generally of greater effective creel, ARETI.C, or noise figure, than low noise microwave receivers. TLIK laser radar can employ the equivalent of either the microwave video receiver or the SIPKRLIKTORIDAN receiver. TLI FO.RIER is called an incoherent, envelope, receiver or direct pleiotode auction. TLIK INKR is called a coherent, heterodyne, receiver or photo mixer. Ulyuri TLI background noise is low and for short pulse modulation the laser envelope detector can operate as a QT ARID or NLITNIK device and give essentially the same detectability, inverse of the noise equivalent power, as heterodyne detector. This is unlike microwaves where the video detector is far less sensitive. TLI heterodyne, or photomixing, receiver can have a narrow pass barid arid significantly reduced TLI effects of background noise. Its sensitivity also CAR1 approach that of an ideal quantum detector. The photomixing receiver is more complicated than the direct photo detection receiver and it requires a stable transmitter and local oscillator. Ulyuri TLI target is in motion relative to the radar. A large Doppler frequency shift occurs which can place the echo signal outside TLI receiver passband. For example, with a relative velocity of 5 m/s, 10 kt, the Doppler frequency shift at 1 pm wavelength is 10 MHz. A rapidly tuning laser local oscillator or a large bank of IF filters are necessary to compensate for TLI/ARG Doppler frequency shift. When the target is in tile far field of the laser antenna, and if the antenna beam is larger TLI reflect target, TLI isual form of TLI simple radar equation of sector 1.2 applies. However, the Beaton-Whitley rather TLI the antenna gain is usually measured at laser frequencies so that, equals NZ/OINABSILBSTETRLTED into the radar equation. TLI minimum detectable signal for Quaratuni Lernik Deuxiural ISR 5-11, equals required nanometer of signal photoelectrons, Q equals quantum efficiency of the detector, and R equals observation time. With likely substitutions, and with 2B equals L/R, assuming a video. TLI minimum detectable signal for Quaratuni Lernik Deuxiural ISR 5-11, equals required nanometer of signal photoelectrons, Q equals quantum efficiency of the detector, and R equals observation time. With likely substitutions, and with 2B equals L/R, assuming a video receiver, the radar equation can be written other radar topics 565, Fig 14.15. THC attenuation in rain however is still large. Thus laser radars operating in the infrarct and visilk regions ACCK THC ADVIL tags off high angular resolution, wide bandwidth, and Doppler frequency sensitivity without the accompanying disadvantage of high attenuation as experienced in the submillimeter ion. Because of its small physical aperture, a laser radar is not suited for most surveillance applications. It is, however, well suited for precision measurement and target imaging. The design of a laser radar follows the same general principles as other radars, HUD with some exceptions. ARS.93.94.I05. In addition to using a transmitter unlike those found at microwave frequencies, the laser RADA IXLG bits OT her DIR lairances that illest be accounted for when considering radar design. For example, the receiver sensitivity is not determined by thermal noise as at microwaves, but by quantum effects. The noise power per unit bandwidth at most laser frequencies is given by NO equals high, 14.3 R, 14.39, / V here 2 equals Planck's constant equals 6.626 × 10 J/L/J.S, and F equals frequency. The familiar expression for thermal noise power at microwave frequencies, NO equals KT, where K equals Boltzmann's constant and T equals absolute temperature, does not apply when KT high. It is the coarseness of the laser signal itself, due to its quantized nature, that ultimately sets the limit to sensitivity as given by FQ, 14.3 R. By settling KJ equals IL, an equivalent noise temperature can be obtained for a laser receiver. At the CO2 laser wavelength of 10.611 m, I equals 1360 K, and at 1.011 m wavelength 7 equals 14.400 K, which indicates that laser radar receivers are generally of greater effective temperature, or noise figure, than low noise microwave receivers. The laser radar can employ the equivalent of either the microwave video receiver or the super heterodyne receiver. The former is called an incoherent, envelope, receiver or direct photo detection. The latter is called a coherent, heterodyne, receiver or photo mixer. When the background noise is low and for short pulse modulation, the laser envelope detector can operate as a quantum-limited device and give essentially the same detectability, inverse of the noise equivalent power, as heterodyne detectors. This is unlike microwaves where the video detector is far less sensitive. The heterodyne, or photomixing, receiver can have a narrow passband and significantly reduce the effects of background noise. Its sensitivity also can approach that of an ideal quantum detector. The photomixing receiver is more complicated than the direct photodetection receiver, and it requires a stable transmitter and local oscillator. When the target is in motion relative to the radar, a large Doppler frequency shift occurs, which can place the echo signal outside the receiver passband. For example, with a relative velocity of 5 mls, 10 kHz, the Doppler frequency shift at IJM wavelength is 10 MHz. A rapidly tuning laser local oscillator or a large hank of IF filters are necessary to compensate for the Farge Doppler frequency shift. Conclusions. When the target is in the far field of the laser antenna, and if the antenna beam is larger than the target, the usual form of the simple radar equation of sector 1.2 applies. However, the beam width rather than the antenna gain is usually measured at laser frequencies, so that advanced radar in SAR can also be developed.